Clerk, if you will please read the announcement and call the roll.
Please be advised this meeting is being taped for video and audio broadcast. Assisted listening devices are available. Mr. Bonifant?
Here.
Mr. Corsello?
Present.
Mr. Hempstead? Mr. Kimmel?
Here.
Mr. Facinelli?
Here.
Ms. Melendez?
Here.
Mr. Sarasis?
Present.
Ms. Bowman?
Here.
Mr. Sims? Mr. Kites?
Here.
Ms. Maggio?
Present.
Mr. De Palma?
Here.
Ms. O'Toole Giandurco? Mr. Igneri?
Here.
Mr. Livingston?
Here.
12 present.
12 present. We have a quorum. Next item on the agenda is the acceptance of the minutes of the regular meeting of April 26, 2016. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Mr. Igneri moves. Any corrections, additions, deletions? Seeing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Abstentions? Mr. Corsello abstains. Motion carries. Next item, public participation.
No one.
No one is signed to address the council. Does anybody wish to address the council? Seeing none, public participation is closed. There are no resignations or appointments on the agenda this evening or reappointments. Under Mayor's remarks, I have a couple. First and foremost, congratulations to our own Councilwoman Shannon O'Toole Giandurco and to her husband Joe. For the birth of their first child, Emily Rose. We congratulate them and welcome them to our council family. Next item on the agenda is something very important. Tomorrow, the Department of Transportation will be holding two public hearings on the Walk Bridge project. We've had several meetings with them and several updates, and right now they're about a 30% design phase, and they want to bring the public into the process and explain exactly what's happening, give them a time frame, etc. And so it's very important that you be there if you have any questions that you'd like to ask them. And I know it's been put in the paper in the hour, so we expect that at both of those meetings we will have some attendance. So the first meeting is from 4:30 to 6:30, and the second meeting is 7 o'clock till 9 o'clock. I believe it's in the community room.
May I ask, are both presentations identical?
Yes.
Okay.
The only difference will be the participants and the questions they may ask.
Okay.
Yeah. Friday, May 13th is International Human Rights Day, and it's being celebrated at Side by Side Charter School at 10 a.m. Also on Friday, Columbus School will observe their mission landing for young astronauts. I don't know if the council people have ever been there, but it's a very interesting program where they go through a whole year of preparing for their space mission. And it's really quite interesting, and it's very realistic. So they really enjoy having people there. So if you can make it, that'd be nice.
When is that, sir?
This is Friday the 13th at 10 o'clock. I'm not sure. Yeah, I guess it's at 10 o'clock. But
yeah, the invite, I think, came with our packet.
It's in your packet.
Okay.
Yeah, and an email, too.
Oh, I didn't get
and
it.
And Saturday, May 14th, we have a program for seniors, but for everybody, on how to avoid frauds and scams. We're having the Commissioner of Consumer Protection, Jonathan Harris, who will be talking about different scams and frauds that they see out there, and the people that are reporting to them, the things that are happening. So we hope to have a good participation. Direct Solar Energy will be there to encourage Norwalk property owners to consider converting to solar. And once again, the New England Smart Energy Group will be there to offer LED lights for the first 100 participants. Thank you, Mr. Kites. Saturday is also Norwalk High School's 17th annual campus cleanup from 9 o'clock until 12:30. If you can make it there, it's really interesting. They do a tremendous amount of work. They do plantings. They get so much accomplished in the 3.5 hours. They usually have about 50 or 60 young people and parents out there volunteering, and teachers, by the way, staff. So it's really very nice to go visit. And please do not forget that on Sunday, May 22nd, the annual Shea McGrath Memorial Service will take place at Cap Pasture Beach. And there will be a special performance in the afternoon by a American Festival band at 4:30 in the concert hall, followed by a reception. And at around 2 o'clock, I believe, we're having a special dedication in the Hall of Honor regarding new items that will be on display, war memorabilia and other things. That is all that I have right now, Mr. Kimmel.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Just for the record, the council has completed two public hearings. We've held on the charter. They're interesting. A number of folks came out. And just earlier this evening, we had what I believe is a very productive workshop with members of the Charter Revision Commission. And we're moving along. And our meeting on May 24th, we will begin digging into and evaluating and passing judgment on the report. Thank you. That's all I have to say. This week, this meeting, the consent calendar is to be read by Eloisa Melendez. Mr. Saccinelli, you are next meeting, I believe. Okay? Ms. Melendez, you have the floor.
Okay, thank you. Before I read the consent calendar, I'd like to make a motion to amend the agenda and to take off items 7C, 1, and 2. They were accidentally put back on our agenda. We actually voted for them last meeting.
Okay, there's a motion on the floor to remove. This is a first for me. I think however we do it will be okay. We don't want to remove everything twice. So everybody who would like to remove from the agenda what we voted on 2 weeks ago, please raise their hand. Okay, thank you. Okay, if we need a ruling from our corporation council, whether we did right or wrong, we'll get it later.
I think we're okay.
Okay, so it's officially off.
Say.
Read it.
Do we have to vote on them separately as a package?
We don't know yet. We don't know.
All right. Okay, so under land use and building management, 7A1 or 1A, authorize the purchasing agent to issue a purchase order to Inselco Corporation for the purchase of classroom furniture for the Norwalk Early Childhood Center based on state contract pricing. Cost shall be for total not to exceed $125,285.91. The account number is noted. Item 1B, or 7A1B, authorize the purchasing agent to issue increases to the purchasing order for a total not to exceed $2,500. 2A, authorize the purchasing agent to issue a purchase order to E-Plus for the purchase of IT network equipment for Norwalk Early Childhood Center based on state contract pricing. Cost shall be a total not to exceed $53,337.43. The account number is noted. Item 2B, authorize the purchasing agent to issue increases to the purchase order for a total not to exceed $2,500. Under planning, number 2, approve the CDBG citizen participant plan. Is that off?
You're fine.
Oh, sorry. It's a really good hearing. Okay. B3, approve the applications listed in the attached memo for referral to the state for inclusion in the 2016 NAA tax credit program. Skipping over ordinance. D, public works. Authorize the purchasing agent to issue a purchase order to VSI Sales LLC for the purchase of replacement 45 mast arm for sum not to exceed $16,726. The account number is noted. That's the consent calendar.
Okay. Any changes in the consent calendar? Okay. Hearing none, all those in favor of the consent calendar as read, please raise their hand. Okay, passes unanimously. Okay. Any opposed? John, I can't see. John?
Nope.
No, I mean, I'm off. Okay.
It passes unanimously. Okay, thank you. Mr. Mayor, I think I'm done. You have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. Kimmel. Mr. Kites, item 7B1.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Item 7B1. I'm sorry.
Excuse me. I actually asked to have it taken off, but then it was. Then I realized somewhere in that packet, there's someone that's, I wanted to say something about it, but somebody in there is paying me for some of the work I do. So Ms. Strauss was pointed out to me that I might best off recuse myself.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Please let the record reflect that Mr. Bonifant has left the chambers along with Elvis.
He wanted it off now.
Okay. Well, now we have to vote on it because it was not it was taken off.
So I'll read it.
So 7B1.
Yeah, but he still has to read it.
Okay. Item 7A1. Excuse me. 7B1. Authorize the mayor to execute any and all documents associated with the submission of the PY42AAP to HUD by May 15, 2016, and all documents consistent with the approved 2015 to the 2019 consolidated plan and PY42 annual action plan.
Mr. Cotties has moved the item. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor? Opposed? Abstentions? Carries unanimously. Thank you. Mr. Cotties, 7B4A.
I believe Mr. Sarras would like to recuse himself from these items.
Yes, I have to recuse myself from these items as I'm putting in a proposal to the theater to be able to stream concerts to China.
So this is all the four items, Mr. Sarras?
Well, they all involve the theater. Okay, yeah. So I think.
So please let the record reflect that Mr. Sarras has recused himself for items 7B4A, 4B, and 4C and has left the chambers as well. Mr. Cotties.
Thank you. Item 7-4-B, approve the attached 7-4-A, approve the Norwalk Redevelopment Agency as the borrower of the Section 108 loan funds for the purpose of the Globe Theater redevelopment project. I'm going to move these all, Mr. Mayor. Item 7-4-B, approve the attached 2015 certified financial statements of the Norwalk Redevelopment Agency as evidence of the NRA's financial capacity to repay the Section 108 loan and an additional security for the guaranteed loan as required by HUD. Item 7-4-C, approved to form the attached Common Council consent resolution to be approved by the Common Council prior to Redevelopment Agency closing on the loan with the Wall Street Theater Company, Inc., which will not be unreasonably withheld. And if, Mr. Mayor, before you call for a vote, I'd like to move that, but before I'd like to propose an amendment to said resolution, six paragraph, have it changed from Wall Street Theater Company, Inc. Wall Street Theater Company, Inc., and has made such underwriting available to the Common Council for its approval prior to the closing of the loan. I'd like to change, it's now review prior to the closing of the loan. I'd like to change the word review to approval. I'd like to move that as amended.
So there's been an amendment to the resolution proposed by Councilman Cotties. Is there any further discussion on that amendment?
It's in the backup information.
All in favor of the amendment, please signify. Opposed? Abstentions? That carries. And now, is there any further discussion on the items of Mr. Bonifant?
Oh, thanks. I guess my understanding of all this is somewhere in there, there's a loan for $1,666,166,000. Are we the ultimate co-signer on that note? I guess the redevelopment. I'll ask
Mr. Sheehan, would you step down?
The structure of the note is that it's basically the pledge of future block grant is the security associated with the note. But HUD asks that there be additional security evidenced, and what is being evidenced is the agency's ability to repay the note. The maximum exposure on an annual basis is a little over $90,000. On the 20-year term, the agency, I think, has effectively demonstrated through the financials that you have that it's got the capacity to cover that debt. So what you're being asked to consider is ultimately the agency being the borrower, and what we're evidencing back to you is our ability to repay the note. But the funding source it goes out to the investor market, and HUD basically uses the guarantee of the block grant as future insurance that the funds can be repaid to the investors.
Okay. they look unfavorably when they grant us block grants, when we are allocated block grants funding? Would they look unfavorably upon that if in a bad situation that most of the block grants were, instead of going to the community to help them, had to end up paying off a loan that a theater owner defaulted on?
Well, ultimately, in this situation, it wouldn't be the theater owner that would be responsible for the default. It would be the redevelopment agency.
Okay.
And what we talked about in committee is the likelihood that the redevelopment agency is going to default on this, the city's pledge of community development block grant funds is highly unlikely.
Right. And according to your financials, you had like over $4 million anyway, like just sitting in your bank?
Just sitting in the bank? No. I mean, that's what's available to the agency, but it doesn't just sit in the bank.
Oh. Where is it?
Well, there's funding that the agency has that can actually undertake programs like this so that we can step in and make the pledge back to the city that we can repay this pledge with the resource.
Right. But in the end, if nobody pays it back, the city does.
In the end, the block grant ultimately is the if every other source basically defaults, the block grant is the final pledge.
And what if block grants don't happen? They will. We know that.
There's been, since the early 1970s, the city's received an entitlement every year. And ultimately, will continue to receive an entitlement as of right.
Okay. Thanks.
Mr. Kimmel.
Mr. Sheen, how many years have we been discussing this in the council? This particular issue with the loan, about three?
No, I would say it's closer to about seven.
Okay. So I recall, I think it was roughly about 3 years ago, when I was involved in some discussions, probably came in the middle of this process, thinking back on it, and you probably remember, we had a lot of questions about the jeopardizing our block grant funding. Now, if I remember correctly, this loan, last term we devised a number of lawyers devised what we all applauded was we minimized the risk to the city. And this loan is, there'll be no transfer of funds at all until there's a CO for the building. Is that correct?
That's correct. The concern at the committee level and within the agency as well was that we didn't want to put the funding at risk during the construction process.
Right.
So we basically had the loan coming into play after the CO was issued, and we would take out the construction financing.
Right. We worked that out last council, right here and in committee. If I remember correctly, also there are some conditions that still have to be met. Business plan, market studies, stuff like that,
loan
to be transferred to the Wall Street company.
I think it's important for the council to understand that the Section 108 loan itself has not been formally approved by HUD. Mm-hmm. What has been approved by HUD is our request for Section 108 loan assistance. So there's a whole underwriting process that has yet to go associated with this loan. And as part of that underwriting process, obviously, the business plan has been an important component of that.
Right. So I'm working under the impression, which was formulated several years ago, that we have minimized our risk, and that one of the worst case scenarios would involve us getting a totally refurbished theater, and at the same time possibly losing a couple hundred thousand of HUD money.
Well, ultimately, I think you're in a better situation than what you just outlined.
Well, that's good.
At the end of the day, the redevelopment agency would be in the position of taking the asset because we would be in first position on the note, and the note would be between the redevelopment agency and the theater, and the agency ultimately would take out your payment.
Right. So this is a rather convoluted issue. But for those who were not on the council last term, the our corporation counsel redevelopments have structured this in a way that really minimizes our risks. And we went into this with a fairly high level of skepticism. We didn't think they would ever pull it off. And from what Mr. Sheehan has related to us recently, they actually seem to be moving forward. It's something we had our fingers crossed about. We didn't think it would happen, but we were hoping it would happen, and this might work. So I'm very, very pleased that we're still moving forward in this.
Further discussion, Ms. Bowman.
Just a couple questions. Do we know what type of programming they will be having in the theater once it's built?
They'll be doing performances and community-based programming.
Okay. And then if they default, what is the max amount per year that will be taken from the CDBG?
Well, again, it's important for us all to recognize the structure. The borrower in this case is now the Norwalk Redevelopment Agency, and the likelihood that the Norwalk Redevelopment Agency is going to default on the CDBG program is highly unlikely. The maximum amount that the Norwalk Redevelopment Agency would be looking at assuming in terms of responsibility would be $90,000 on an annual basis.
Okay. And then, my understanding is redevelopment, so redevelopment is first, and then in the event that, then it's CDBG, right?
That is correct. Redevelopment agency is first, and then if we defaulted, then there would be HUD would then look to your entitlement.
Okay. And are we saying that you all are financially stable enough to do it with
the resources that we have?
Okay.
Further discussion? Seeing none, all in favor? Opposed? Abstentions? Unanimous. Thank you. Mr. Ignari.
Make a motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn. All in favor?